Hey everyone, welcome to my channel. I wasn't going to do this topic at first, but Spirit said no, do the topic. When I was in meditation, this is the topic, okay? It's what's going on in the spirit realm right now. This is very important because you see, usually I have three piles. Today I have four, so there's a lot going on. If you feel drawn to more than one pile, definitely listen to your intuition and pick as many piles as you are drawn to. Please, please keep in mind this is still a general collective reading. So if certain things don't resonate, you don't have to comment and let me know. That's okay. That means it's for someone else, okay? Other parts might be for you, okay? So, if you're new here, my name is Aimee the Goddess. I appreciate all of my new subscribers. I appreciate all my current ones. Y'all are so freaking loyal. I appreciate it. And trust me, I'm gonna remember those of y'all rocking with me when I get my little 1 mil one day, okay? Thanks for liking the video, thanks for subscribing, and if anyone wants to book a personal, information will be down in the description box. Also, I'm just gonna say trigger warning on all my readings because I never know what's gonna come out of my mouth. My spirit team is crazy, okay? Sometimes in a good way, sometimes in a not good way. I love them though, okay? So, here's the four piles. Pile one is the yellow jar. Well, it has a yellow lid. Pile two is the starfish. Pile three is that Egyptian hieroglyphic tower. And pile four, why did I want to say melting pot? It's the little cauldron, which is pot. Am I hungry? I don't know. Okay. So, with all that being said, we're going to start with pile one, which is the jar with the yellow lid. Why did I do that? I did the opposite. Alright, jar with the yellow lid, pile one. Welcome to your reading. Before we get in here fully, I'm going to play my little instrument just to clear the sound. Clear the vibrations over here with the sound is what I meant to say. Okay. Alright. I got my instrument. It's a tongue drum, by the way. I'm glad we waited because that guy walked and I felt awkward. Okay, I was drawn to number four. That's the number of that note for you guys, so four might be very significant. Okay, pile one. What's going on in the spirit realm right now that you should be aware of? Wow, did you just hear that? I'm hearing Freaky Friday. Have you guys seen the movie Freaky Friday? I think Jamie Lee Curtis was in it. This movie is significant for your life right now, where like you and someone else switched places. I don't know if necessarily in that movie is her mom. It was the mom and the daughter that switched places. However, I'm not sure if that's necessarily the case for you, but you did switch places with someone at some point, someone that you could have lived with. That's why I say that, because the Four of Wands, which is about home. We'll get more information here, okay, Pile One. Give me a second to pull this together. You switched back, though, because it says home, so you made it back home. You're back in your own body. But you did, for a while, switch with someone. Who did Pile 1 switch with? Oh, two different people. Child and father. Child and father had switched places on a soul level. Some of you didn't know your dad. Or you thought you knew your dad, but really your dad was someone different. But a father and a child switched places. For some of you, this could have been you and your partner that switched places. I'm hearing swapped. I keep thinking of wife swapped, but it's like you switched places with them. Either a father or a baby daddy. Because like I said, it's someone that you lived with. The wind is knocking these cards over, so I don't know how I can really show you them. But what I can tell you is that you switched back, and that's why you could be feeling a bit different. It's like you felt really different, not in a good way, for a while, and now you're feeling more like you're back to yourself again because your guys' spirits swapped. I don't know if it was necessarily your souls. I think your souls were the same. But you guys, keep in mind, a soul and a spirit is not the same thing. A soul can be in several different bodies. You know, like, think of the soul like the USB. Like a USB, where it holds several information on it. Several different spirits can go through that soul. As in, you can have many past lives with different spirits, but that's still the same soul. Hopefully I'm explaining that correctly. So basically, your spirit swapped, not your souls, is what I'm getting. Why did this have to happen? Change. This was at a time when someone was low on money or low on finances, or like literally they were out of a job when this happened. And you switched back at some type of party or celebration or get together, because we have the Three Cups next. You and this person were always fighting, so somehow your souls came to an agreement to swap spirits to see what it's like. There's a trash truck coming. Hold on, let me pause what I'm saying. This is interesting. So now it's saying, it says here, provider. So, like I said, a provider would be like more of a masculine energy that you swapped with. We have chosen one. So you guys could be chosen for a spiritual path or to be some type of prophet. And this person had to see the pressure of what it's like to hold a purpose like that. And you had to see what it's like for them to hold the pressure of being a provider. You guys both had pressure in different areas. Okay. And it was also to help you guys get along better, because you guys were always fighting or not understanding each other. So you guys were meant to see what it's like to be in each other's shoes. It says fake it till you make it. So it's just like you knew you didn't feel right. Like something felt off or something. You were feeling off for a while. But like I said, it could have been a baby daddy or someone that is like your baby daddy. You know, like someone that you're dating long term that does take care of your kids or kid. So you finally switched back, though. So you should be feeling back to yourself or starting to again. You'll be able to, like, look in the mirror, see who you are. For some of you, somebody cursed this person not you, but the curse, the person you swapped with, and you were supposed to swap with them to help them on a spiritual level to overcome that, since you're the spirit, more spiritual one, and they're more the provider one. So yeah, that's also what I'm getting here. Very straightforward message. I can't keep this video too long, since now I have to upload videos, since my live wants to act stew. So let's go to pile two. Give this a thumbs up if this resonated, or if it seems like this could be your story, or even if it was just entertaining and you liked that.
I like it like that.
All right, let's go to pile. La 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 la.
La 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 la. La 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 la. La 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 la. Do 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 do.
That's the song I'm thinking of. Obviously, I cannot hit that fucking whistle note, but that's what this pile is making me think of. That song.
Loving you is easy because you're beautiful.
What the hell? This is definitely like a love, romantic type of thing coming through right now. Let's see. Where did my cards go? Here they are.
Okay, Divine Femme.
What's going on in the spirit realm? There's actually... Okay. You chose the fucking starfish, and the Empress came out, which is giving me goddess vibes. There is a goddess, and she's more of a water goddess of some sort. Like, maybe she's a siren, some type of mermaid. Did you hear... Maybe that's why I was thinking of that song, because it was so high-pitched, right? Like a siren. She has to do with the water. This goddess has to do with the water. So this might be a goddess that's wanting to work with you that maybe you never even heard of. Maybe you have slightly heard of her. Maybe it's not the goddess you currently work with, but a new one's coming in to want to work with you. She's been channeling through you through certain songs, as well as the way you've been doing your makeup lately. Or the way that she's going to try to get you to do your makeup. Or for my men, you know, the way you dress. I've been wanting to style your hair. Your cologne you've been wearing. Maybe that's why you're drawn to water so much. Let's get more information.
Loving you.
She's coming in to help you heal your self-love wound, your feminine energy, your creativity, all of that. She's helping you to forgive yourself as well as other people. Some of you are holding a grudge on yourself you need to let go of in order to move on to the new chapter. Things haven't been moving. You've been like very stagnant in certain areas of your life, whether it's career, finances, life purpose, spirituality, wherever you feel like you've been held back, this is why. It's until you forgive yourself for a certain grudge you're holding on yourself, as well as maybe some other people too. And this could be incidences where you don't even think of, like small incidences, like somebody flicked you off in traffic and like you have so much hate for that person, you need to let it go. Like, it might not be something super big. Maybe you already forgive the big stuff. Maybe it's the small stuff. In terms of other people, at least. But you guys don't see that she's been next to you. She's been working with you, and you don't even know it. You're, like, completely oblivious. But if you were to meditate, you would see her. You would hear from her. Let's see, what else does she want you to know?
What's love?
Got to do with it, babe. She wants you to imagine what it is you want to happen in love. I'm hearing Imagine by Ariana Grande. Literally imagine how you want your love life to be. I think that you would really benefit from a romantic love life, because that's what your soul wants, but maybe you haven't received that fully. So write it down, envision it, and let it happen for you. You deserve romance. The person, if you're talking to someone or dealing with someone now, they have potential to deliver you a romantic life or connection. She's drawing you to take certain spiritual baths. I feel like she's drawing you to get certain ingredients. Okay, so whenever you go shopping for like bath stuff, bathroom decorations, bath soaps, bath salt, whatever like that, maybe even certain herbs, it's her working through you to put it in the bath. Influencer. Some of you are meant to be influencers, and she's helping you get onto that path. And she wants to help you to become an influencer. Maybe you already are, but she's going to help you get really out there. Okay? So that's what's going on in the spirit realm for you, Pal 2. Do, do, do. Do, 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 do. Do, 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 do. Pal 3, welcome to your reading. Let's clear the energy. For you, the number is 6. I didn't feel drawn to do it for the last reading. For you, the number is 6, and I keep hearing a certain song, 666, party with the devil, bitch. It's by Attila. That's the channeled song coming through right now. Don't believe me, just watch. I'm hearing that song too. Don't believe me, just watch. Bruno Mars. I don't know what song that is. Shoot. You guys have traveled somewhere where the town, I don't know if it was the town or the land that is used to summon entities. Could be a certain land in a town that you went out of town, or you're about to go out of town somewhere, and there's a certain land there that was used to summon entities or demons. Someone was trying to summon the actual devil. Wow, I shit you fucking not. The devil card came out, and there's a weird noise happening in my kitchen over there. So, like I said, someone was trying to summon that entity. Why? Because they're facing bankruptcy, and they know that they would get help being rich. So, it's probably a sociopath or, you know, something like that, a crazy person. Well, I don't want to say all sociopaths are crazy, because some of them are getting help and they're good people. But this person's not. It's like, they're literally like, they don't care if they harm people. They just want to do this to get money and be rich and live the life they want. Yeah, so a lot of dark spiritual shit was going on there in that place that you went to. Because they're facing bankruptcy. They were doing shit to get money. Doing shit just for money. Making some sort of contract, summoning a bunch of entities, as well as trying to summon the actual devil. Ooh, my throat feels like it's like gonna bleed on this pile. So I don't know if I want to stay on this pile too long. Because maybe I'm not supposed to say this information. But you'll notice that there'll be a lot of hieroglyphics in that town. Or at a concert. Or, you know, graffiti that has certain knowledge on it that you should pay attention to kind of let you know. You need to cleanse and have a bunch of protection on after going to this place and protection on going to this place. Could be a lot of golden colors. A lot of statues maybe somewhere or buildings in this area. Or a lot of nature, trees. It could go either way. I'm seeing like multiple different places in my mind right now in my third eye. But a lot of animals die there is what I'm getting. Like birds just fall out of the sky when they fly over this area. So a lot of animals might not even want to be in that area. Not even like mosquitoes might not even want to be in that area. I'm seeing someone have like a lot of scars or tattoos. A particular person that was trying to summon something. It could have been groups of people. Okay. It could have definitely been groups of people. Let's pull some cards from my box that I channeled. Paranoid. So when you're in this area, you start to get paranoid, or people in general get paranoid because they can pick up on that energy, right? And also the entities might mess with people. As I said, they're doing this just to win, just to get money, just to succeed or win at something in life. Equal rights, for some of you, the equal rights that's been going on, or like, you know, how you vote for certain areas, it could have been being summoned for that as well. Something like political. It has here Pisces, which is just another card representing some spiritual shit going on. Anything else? Bully. So yeah, it might not be everyone that's involved in that, but there's certain people involved in that. Like if this was a concert or some type of label place, some type of building, like big chain building that's around here where they do it on this field, or like this certain like area. I don't know how to explain it really, but some people might not be involved in that, but there is people that are involved in that. And you just got to be careful. I got a heart flutter. Product of your environment. It's really telling you not to go around there. You have to cleanse like immediately after. It could be near water. A water sign could be the one doing it though. Even if you're a water sign, it's a different one. Anger. There's a lot of anger being released. You can notice people getting violent in that area. That's why. So if you've been to this place, you need to cleanse. Maybe don't go to that place again. I'm thinking of Spooky Island on Scooby-Doo. So it could be an island or a place like that. Or it's like a carnival or a fair where it could be a theme park. Like I said, it could be like big buildings, like corporate buildings that are all like a chain connected, or it's like an actual just a field or a forest, a park. I'm hearing a field maybe where they throw concerts or put fairs, you know, that's what I'm thinking of. I'm gonna leave this here, guys. Be careful going back to that place, okay? Or when you go to that place. Okay, give me a thumbs up if that resonated. I appreciate it. Pile 4, what's going on in the spirit realm? This is going to be a deep message already. Two songs I'm channeling. Dancing with the devil. Walking side by side. Me and the devil. And then I just sold my soul for a kilo. two songs here, and I'm channeling messages already, and I think that this was the main reason, if you chose this pile, that I was supposed to do this reading, because that's the song I was hearing in meditation. Someone sold their soul in your family to the devil, or they intended to. Devil's a certain entity. As you guys know, Satan, the devil, Lucifer, all different entities. The devil is actually very evil and harms children and all that stuff. Now, if they did it to Satan or Lucifer, that wouldn't be as big of a deal. They're not terrible entities. The devil, the actual devil, yes, that is a terrible entity. That's the one that people use to sacrifice children and things like that. So I don't agree with that. Ooh, I'm getting dizzy in this reading. Okay, guys, let's hurry up and fucking get to it. Someone in your family sold their soul to the devil. This person could have ended up, one, offing themselves, two, paralyzed and died of natural causes. Or maybe they're still alive, but they're paralyzed. Let's get more information. Think of Pearl. If you guys ever seen Pearl on Netflix, this person wanted to be famous and they wanted to be rich. I'm going to be a star someday. But they didn't live up to their end of the deal, which is why they ended up paralyzed or killing themselves. Trigger warning. Should have said that before. Well, I did say it in the beginning of this video. Or very sick, or like something happened to them. Why? Because they didn't live up to their end of the deal with the devil. It says, refusing to compromise. This person didn't compromise with the devil. They were obsessed with status. It says self-absorbed, financial independence, imbalance of family and work. So they didn't even care that they were putting their own family at risk. Dependence, obsessed with status. And you ended up being the one that may get this fame. Be careful if this ancestor is around you, because they're going to try, because they're a sociopath ancestor. You can't always trust your ancestors, guys. That is a trickster spirit. In your circle, that they try to get in with your spirit team. So make sure you're always using protection before readings or before doing anything. When you're working with your ancestors, understand who all you're working with. Because they're planning to go through your body to live out this fame. Basically, I don't know if it's soul swapping or putting their spirit in your body, but something along those lines here. Me and the devil. Look up that song. It's actually a really good song. Look up that song. I feel like for a lot of you, this is an ancestor you don't know. Because in the beginning I said, okay, they could still be alive. No, it could have affected that person that is still alive, if anything. Because I'm getting that this ancestor is dead. We have the death card. So it's actually someone that's dead already. But it could have tried to affect someone that is paralyzed. Someone that's blood related. So if you had like a partner that died or killed themselves, that's not who it is. This is someone that's blood related. They've been gone for at least a generation now. Or this was like a great grandparent or a great great grandparent. Something like that. Or a cousin somewhere in the great greats. Oh, something's touching my back. Oh God, I don't like that. Okay, let's keep going. the moon cards on the bottom. So yeah, they're deceptive. If you've been getting messages that you can't trust someone in your circle, it's not someone physical, it's someone spiritual, it's this fucking ancestor. Because you could be getting like signs like, oh, you can't trust this person around you, and you're thinking, okay, you're around me, you're mommy, can I not trust you? You can trust those people. This is someone that's around you spiritually, because they know you're going to get fame at some point, or a lot of money, a large sum of money, $1 million. If you're a $1 million baby, that's you guys. You're literally going to be worth $1 million, or you already are, something. Maybe some of you already have the fame, and that's why they're trying to come through here. I'm literally thinking of Jelly Roll's wife. What is her name? Snow Bunny. Bunny. This is her reading. Other people might, obviously, everyone else in here too, but if she ever were to see this reading, she would choose pile number 4, and this would be her reading. Maybe she needs to know this. Should I send her this? She probably wouldn't even fucking open it. I never think of Bunny like that either. I never think of her. I don't know how I'd do that, but... yeah, I don't think I can tell her that. Like, she might get offended if I just go in her inbox and I'm like, hey, this reading's for you. Like, she might think I'm like fake. So I don't know if I'll do that. If it's meant for her to find this video, she will, by her spirit team. Yes. 4, the Empress. So you guys are very high up there already. Look, you're gonna have something worth celebrating soon. Careful celebrating with this freaking ancestor that's trying to come through. If you guys seen Pearl on Netflix, I'm telling you, go watch it. That's exactly this ancestor. Planning to travel. Some of you are gonna be hitting something big soon of your own. Like, you know how Bunny got famous, not from herself, but kind of off Jelly Roll. You're gonna have something that blows up yourself. If that's the case, it's gonna be a lot of money as well. Okay, I'm gonna leave this pile here because it's getting deep, but you guys need to do mad protection, banish that ancestor. Okay, we've been hearing a lot about foxes or sneaky people. Is this ancestor? Don't leave out food for this ancestor. Nothing. You'll know when their energy's around. It doesn't feel right. Okay, but they might know your spiritual passwords, so you're gonna need to do something about that. Tell your other ancestors something. I love you guys. Thanks for joining me. Stay safe. Like the video. Subscribe. Turn on the notification bell. And if you want a personal, information's down in the description box. Don't get scammed by scammers pretending to be me. I'll never reach out to you first. Make sure you guys follow my TikTok, my Instagram, my Facebook. I'll post it down below in the timestamps, okay? Bye. And also, thanks for everyone donating. I love you.